वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला अंडर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंडियन कल्चर वी हैव द पेपर प्री हिस्टोरिक एंड प्रोटो हिस्टोरिक कल्चर्स ऑफ इंडिया अंडर दिस सब्जेक्ट वी हैव द मॉड्यूल रॉक आर्ट ऑफ इंडिया दिस मॉड्यूल वॉज रिटन बाय ऊर्मी घोष बिस्वास आई एम सेल्वकुमार असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर at Department of Epigraphy and Archaeology. I am going to explain about Rock Art of India to you. Rock Art of India is a wonderful research subject. All over the world, when we take rock art, it is a very interesting subject. It is very colorful because we see these paintings as well as engravings on the rock surfaces all over the world. What is rock art? Let's define rock art. Rock art is anything that is engraved or painted on the rock surface. Actually, the more appropriate term would be paleo art. One of the earliest human artistic manifestations in the form of paintings and brushings are rock art. Painting in the sense that they take a paint and then they apply on the surface and get a picture. In the case of bruisings, they use some hard material and they either beat it or engrave it on the hard rock surface and then they achieve a image. These are the two different types of methods that were used by the people for creating rock art. Rock art is a global phenomenon. It is found all over the world. Actually, in human nature, it is there to make or to scribble or anything. Even if you give a pen to a small kid, the kid will write something on the paper. Similarly, right from the prehistoric times, humans have engraved on the trees, on the earth, on the rock surfaces. Only those that they wrote on the rock and other permanent materials are preserved. Whatever they wrote on the impermanent materials are lost forever. They are actually records of human history. Rock art is emerging as an important branch of archaeological studies with interdisciplinary approaches. Rock art is a source of history for people who do not have any written document. When a group of people have access to writing, they can write down their history. But there were several groups across the world who did not have the knowledge of writing, but they recorded their daily activities in the rock shelters as well as in the caves. And they serve as an important source of their history. That is why rock art study is very important, and rock art study also involves a component of art. It helps us to understand the human mind and how complicatedly humans were thinking in the past, how they could reproduce what they saw in their real life on the two-dimensional surface. It is seen as an important development in the growth of human cognition, understanding and language and the use of symbols. So cognitive archaeology is an important area that studies the rock art remains from cognitive perspective. Where can we see rock art? Rock art can be found on all kinds of natural surfaces, granite rocks, and also on the earth's surfaces, hill slopes, on big boulders. Generally, they are found in the remote areas and mainly in the hilly areas. Sometimes, rock art is also found on portable objects, small pieces of object in which people engraved. Therefore, you can see rock art in all kinds of landscape, especially in the hilly terrains. Rock art, as I mentioned earlier, are found all over the world. And India has a very rich collection of rock paintings. and rock engravings. Apart from India, we have evidence of rock art in South Africa, Australia, North and South America, as well as in Europe. These rock paintings as well as other forms of art are very interesting indeed, and they tell beautiful stories of human past. The rock art in India has been documented by IGNCA, New Delhi, Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts. They have done excellent documentation, and India possesses very rich concentration of rock art. India is considered one of the other regions in the world to have rich varieties of rock art. You also have evidence of rock art in South Africa and also in Australia. Indian rock art remains are found all over the country. They are found in sandstone or sedimentary mountains, primarily in the Vindhya, Satpura, Aravalli hills of central India. There are also many sites in southern part of India, mainly in the Deccan region. Largest accumulation of sites are found in central India from the states of Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan. In this map, you can see the distribution of rock art sites across India. Some of the important rock art sites are found in central India, which is rich in rock shelters as well as in forest. Many of the important sites are found especially in the state of Madhya Pradesh. We should mention the site of Mimbetka, which is the most important rock art site in India. This has been declared by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. This has a very rich collection of rock art dating from the prehistoric time to the medieval period. In addition to that, we have sites like Jawara, Kathotia, Firangi, Gufa Masir, Lakhojar and Adamgar. Kairwari in Raisen district, Maradau, Badkachar, Mount Rosa, Dorothy Deep, Panarpani in Panchmarhi are the other important rock art sites. In the image, you can see the rock art remains from Mimbetka rock shelter as well as those from Panchmarhi area. North India also has very rich variety of rock art sites. Below in this image are depicted the rock paintings from Mirzapur district in Uttar Pradesh. We have sites such as Dras, Kargil, Mulbek, Nurla, Leh in Ladakh region. Ladakh region has a lot of important rock paintings and engravings, and sites near the city of Chilas on the bank of River Indus in Zanskar Valley also has some of the important rock art remains. In addition to that, Garhwal, Varanasi, Allahabad and Agra in the Ganga Yamuna Valley in Uttar Pradesh also have rich variety of rock art. Mirzapur district in Uttar Pradesh is also another significant area where we find important rock art vestiges. South India is also a very important place in terms of rock art remains, because South India is very famous for its granite hillocks, especially in the Deccan regions. You have beautiful hillocks lying across the landscape. When you walk across these hills, you can notice many of the rock art remains. Especially these rock art remains are coming from the Neolithic dominated area, where you find a lot of castellated hillocks and also water springs nearby. Karnataka is very rich in rock art sites. Kupkallu, Badami, Maski and Piklikal have some of the important rock art remains there. Andhra Pradesh also has very important prehistoric sites with a lot of artifactual remains. The site of Budagavi, Chintagunta, Ketavaram have important rock art remains. Kerala, lying in the southwest coast of India, has some of the unique rock art remains, especially the Idakkal cave and Eduthupara have very interesting rock engravings. They are very unique in India in the sense that they have lot of figures, both human as well as animal figures, engraved on the rock surface, and some of the canvases are very huge. Thus, we have large variety of rock art remains across South India. And Orissa in the eastern part of India also has significant rock art remains. We have several sites documented in these regions. We have Vikram Kol, Gudahanandi, Landimal, Ushakoti, Lekha Moda, Jogimath, Tongo are some of the important rock art sites. Most of the Orissa's rock art is non-figurative and non-thematic. Generally, they have symbols more often. And coming to the chronology of rock of India, rock art of India, we have lot of issues. Rock art is not easily datable. Suppose if we have an archaeological site, we can easily collect sample, send them for radiocarbon or C14 dating. But rock art is a very thin coating found on the rock surface. Sometimes it occurs as engraving. The question is, how can we date these thin films of rock art? It's been a tough task. That is why most of the time rock art is dated on the basis of stylistic grounds. The rock paintings themselves are useful in establishing a relative chronology in the absence of full-fledged absolute chronometric dating, because absolute dating is just not possible. We are not going to get large amount of carbon or organic material from the rock painted surfaces, and moreover we can't just damage the painting just for dating, and we have to use very minutely datable material techniques for dating these rock paintings. Therefore, different parameters are taken into consideration for establishing a relative chronology of the rock art of India, and they are given in this chart. One is superimposition. Sometimes people paint over the earlier paintings. Sometimes you find three or four or five layers of painting. By carefully identifying these layers of painting, we can relatively date them. We can say this layer is earlier than this layer. And in addition to that, in the rock art caves where these rock art was found, we also find archaeological soil sediment with materials. So when you excavate them, you can get relatable material to the paintings. By dating this material, you can indirectly date the rock paintings. Again, themes of the rock art. Sometimes prehistoric paintings more often have hunting scenes. Animal domestication scenes are found more often in the Neolithic period. So just by looking at the themes of the painting, we can date them. Next is style. How complex is style? Sometimes we use the logic of simple to complex. We assume that prehistoric people used a simple style. So we try to attribute the simple paintings with simple style to an early period. Sometimes painting with a complex period to a later period. So this technique is also used for dating. And finally, we can also use the context, overall context of the site, as well as the painting, as well as the archaeological deposit to date the rock paintings. However, we have to be extremely careful in dating rock art. Most of the datings are only tentative. Now the dating techniques are improving. Maybe in future, we may be able to date them more accurately. The nature of rock art, as I mentioned earlier, there are two main categories of rock art. One is called petroglyph, the other is called pictograph. Pictograph is actually a painting on the surface. What happens is they have the rock surface, they take a painting as a separate color, they mix it with water, either it can come from minerals or from the plants, they can extract the juice and make a paste, and then they draw over the surface. Here the process of accretion, they add something to the surface, addition. In the case of petroglyphs, what they do is generally they take a stone or a sharp material, they repeatedly hammer the surface or repeatedly rub or scoop or peck and then create an impression. So this is a reduction strategy. They remove something from the surface and then create a figure. This is called petroglyph. This is how the two important categories are rock art are created. In addition to the images, sometimes we have shallow depression called cupules. They are also found in several sites across India. They are also called as cup marks. They are found as shallow dots, sometimes small holes, sometimes conical or U-shaped cup marks. They probably repeatedly hammered the surface to get these depression. We don't know what was their function was. Probably they have used them for some purpose, or they wanted to create some design by creating them. We don't know their real meaning. Colors used. People have used different kinds of colors for creating rock art. People have used red color very often. The red color was probably obtained from hematite nodules. Hematite has actually iron oxide material. This produces red color. People have used this particular hematite for painting with red color. They have used white color from calcium carbonate nodule or kaolin and other clay deposit. Probably sometime people have also used blood, sometime even ash, and probably they mix them with some kind of gum or other resin so that the painting could last long. Sometimes paintings are done in more than one color. They are called as bichrome pictograph. They have red and white color, and these kind of varieties are also found. Sometimes green and yellow colors are also found in the rock painting. Thus we see a large varieties of colors in the rock paintings. People have ingeniously used different kinds of material to produce colorful rock paintings. And another important point I wanted to make here, apart from this painting the rock surfaces, people were probably painting their bodies also. Unfortunately, we can't find evidence for that, and body painting is kind of a practice which is prevalent among some of the primitive groups even today. So we can assume that people were painting on their bodies also. How they acquired these color, this is also an interesting area. Sometimes they were using colors in the liquid form. That means they were mixing the color powder with water and then they were painting. And sometimes they were not preparing the background at all. They were just simply painting on the surface. And they had different kinds of method for preparing the painting. Sometimes they used organic material and adhesive so that the painting would last long. So you can see that these people have used several methods to create these paintings, which reflects their intelligence as well as creativity. Superimposition. This is another important aspect. This normally we wouldn't do. If somebody has written, you wouldn't go and write on them. But ancient time people were writing over and over again. You don't know why they did that. We find these kind of superimposition and overlapping paintings, and they also occur at several sites. In a way, they indirectly help us to date. So when you have multiple layers of painting, we can easily separate the various layers, the earlier layer and the later layer and the latest layer, by studying their types and also their style. You can indirectly reconstruct a typological sequence which can help us date the painting, though they have done a kind of vandalism. If you could interpret it in a way, helps us to date the paintings. History of rock art research in India. This is also very interesting. Probably people were watching these rock art in ancient time. Nobody bothered to research on them. The research actually starts after the arrival of the European. We don't know if people really did research in ancient India, but we have clear record for the research only from the British time. Actually, Archibald Carlyle, an English officer, was with the Archaeological Survey of India. He first noticed these rock paintings in Kaimur Ranges in Mirzapur district of Uttar Pradesh in 1867 and 68, and that is how rock art study began. And subsequently, several researchers were working on these rock art remains. Especially they were thrilled by their appearance as well as their varieties, and they have brought out a lot of publications. We have Vincent Smith, John Cockburn, Frank, Percy Brown, and A. Ghosh, G.R. Hunter, D.H. Gordon, H. Brodick, Fred Fawcett, and Alchin, Nagaraj Rao, and V.S. Wahankar, and numerous researchers have done studies on these important rock art, and they are available in several books as well as in publications. So when we talk about history of rock art in India, we can't forget Dr. V.S. Wahankar, who was instrumental in the discovery of Bimbetka rock shelters and which are now considered as the World Heritage Site. Now we can call this man as a founder of rock, modern rock art studies in India. His contributions are immense, and especially we should appreciate people like Vahankar, who traveled to the nook of the village region and found many of the archaeological site and especially rock art site. History of rock art, when we deal with the history of rock art research in India, we also need to look at the developments later. We have the Rock Art Society of India, which was founded later, and that also contributed to rock art research. Again, we have Indian Rock Art Research Association, which was established in 1988. At Shantiniketan in West Bengal, that has also contributed to rock art research in India. So these researchers have brought out many of the rock art remains in the remote areas of India. In a sense, they have also preserved these valuable heritage remains. Purakala is a research journal. I think you should consult this particular journal, which has very interesting articles on the rock art found in various parts of India. This journal is very important. It acts as a platform for sharing views. Generally, researchers, when you find a rock art or archaeological remains, they should write an article. They normally write, and that is how they can exchange ideas. Sometimes you find the images which are painted in central India exactly same what is found in southern India. So this helps us to understand the kind of thinking, kind of thought that has gone into the mind of prehistoric people when painting. So this kind of comparative studies are very important. So there are also some government organization which are involved in researching rock art. We have Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts in New Delhi, which has been conducting a lot of rock art exhibitions across India in order to educate the college students as well as school children in the importance of Indian rock art. We have Archaeological Survey of India, Ministry of Culture of under Government of India, taking a lot of research initiative on the rock art. We have Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalaya and National Museum of Mankind in Bhopal that is undertaking research as well as documentation of rock art. These institutions have a lot of data on the rock art remains of India. Then we have Indian Council of Historical Research, Indian Rock Art Research Center at Anjaneri, Maharashtra. These institutions are also supporting rock art research. Understanding the rock art of India. Understanding is very important in pursuing any research discipline. Rock art interpretation is highly challenging. It is like modern art sometimes. When somebody paints something, 10 different people give 10 different meanings. So it is highly difficult to find the true meaning of these rock art remains. India does not have a living tradition of rock art, though a few of the primitive communities or the tribal communities undertake paintings in rock shelters here and there. In countries like South Africa, the San community, and also in Australia, the Aboriginals make rock art even today. And their rock art depict their cultural affiliation. And we should not see these communities as very primitive, though sometimes we tend to use the term primitive, and we should be seeing them on par with us because they are also Homo sapiens, and their rock paintings tell us a lot about their cultural way of life as well as their cognitive aspect of the society. Ethnographic analogs. Sometimes in the rural India, we do get evidence for these remnants of the ancient painting tradition. People in the villages paint on their walls, and also the tradition of kolam also should be considered as a survival of the rock art traditions. We have many communities in India, Sauras, Saura Gonds, Muriyas and Nagas and other communities paint several themes and concept in their walls. They are also indirectly helping us to understand the rock art of ancient times and also their interpretations. So as I mentioned earlier, we do find evidence for rock art among the rural communities. Sometimes they are called as tribes, and some of these communities make very beautiful paintings on their walls, and they are also seen as a new kind of designs. They are also sometimes used in modern jewelry as well as in modern dress and clothes. So the ancient rock art can give lot of ideas in developing designs, and also they can help to create much more attractive designs. That is why studying the art of the tribal community is very important. Sometimes these tribal art are considered to have created as part of shaman, some kind of divine dance performed in ancient societies. That is why we don't know why they were painting. So it is impossible to understand the meaning of these painting unless we find some kind of written evidence. Sometimes these paintings were done to ward off evil spirits. Even in India, even today, sometimes people apply the impression of the hands or some other designs to keep the bad evil away. Perhaps these kind of beliefs only contributed to the development of rock art. Shamanism, as I mentioned earlier, is considered to be one of the important factor in the development of rock art, and also this is related to some kind of magical functions and rituals. This is a peculiar way of looking at life. Though we live in a modern world, we don't understand much of the rituals. Ancient people gave equal importance to rituals and these kinds of belief. In fact, it sometimes helped them psychologically a great deal. That is why they were respecting these kinds of traditions. Let's look into the characteristic features of the rock art in India. Actually, we have early rock art coming from Bimbetkar region. Sometimes they have these petroglyphs which they consider to be of Paleolithic in age because they were buried under the old Paleolithic deposits. And recently, more than 500 cupules have been found in Daraki Chattan near Banpura in Champal Valley. They are also called as Paleolithic. There are again debates on their age, but some scholars consider that these remains are oldest in the world and they are Paleolithic in date. We need to undertake more research on them. The Upper Paleolithic period, we see different kind of styles appearing. Generally, it is believed people did not have language in the very earliest stages of evolution. As they developed language, as they developed symbols for communication, their complexity as well as their way of thinking also improved. This is indirectly reflected in rock paintings. They could conceive complex design and they could paint these designs on the rock surfaces. Coming to the characteristics of the Upper Paleolithic period rock paintings, V.S. Vahankar has associated some of the green colored paintings at Bimbetkar with the Upper Paleolithic period. Stylistically, the early paintings are characterized by a high degree of craftsmanship. That is how scholars consider. And these are considered pre-figurative, before the creation of the drawing of figures, either human or animals, people were writing complex symbols. That is how it is argued that these complex symbols came up much earlier in date. Another characteristic of Upper Paleolithic period is S-shaped human-like figures. They are found in some of the rock paintings. They have been associated with the early period. The S-shape is associated with figures in dynamics. So these kind of designs help us to date rock painting. Sometimes they also express their stylistic focus. Mesolithic rock paintings, generally the rock paintings of different periods show different characteristics. Mesolithic paintings portray a hunting-gathering population, and they have different kinds of techniques and different kinds of methods displayed here. Animal-like forms appear more naturalistic here, while the human figures are very abstract. So this is a kind of method or the style these people adopted. Male human figures appear like a stick, while women are shown slightly bulkier. In addition to that, we have X-ray. X-ray painting is the one that depicts the internal body organs. These kind of X-ray paintings are also seen. Sometimes they relate to human being, sometimes they relate to animals. Again, animal species resembling tiger, elephant, rhinoceros, humped cattle, boar, monkey, rat, porcupine can be drawn in these paintings. Probably these people were wishing that they wanted to hunt these animals. And again, they have weapons resembling spears and arrows, sometimes tipped and barbed, which indicates that these people were using stone tools and they planted them on the wooden sticks and then created composite tools. This in a way indirectly helps us to understand the lithic technology, how these people were using the lithic tools for activities. In addition to that, you have daily activities similar to present day, like butchering, fishing, fruit and honey gathering, dancing and singing. All that is depicted on the rat paintings. Probably these people could not document, they did not have a script to document their feelings. They thought it is easier to document their scenes as paintings directly. That is why we have these rock paintings with us now. And we also have more varieties of painting. Sometimes they have selected certain locations for making lot of paintings. Probably the people were camping at these sites for longer period of time. And even probably they were inspired by the shape of the rocks also for making paintings. And there is a place called Zoo Rock at Bimbetka where they have different representation beautifully depicted here. So a lot of animals and other species are also depicted in these paintings. They indirectly tells their inner feelings, and probably they were wanting to hunt these animals, that is why they were painting them all along. And a few of the Mesolithic engravings have also been found in different parts of India. So Neolithic, Chalcolithic period, we have a different kind of representation in the rock paintings. We have domesticated animals appearing. So we clearly see that domestication had begun and people were displaying these scenes that they were domesticating the animal, and that is displayed in the rock. In addition to that, they were portraying several other scenes, bows and arrows, spears and axes. So, and in addition to that, they were also drawing vehicles like bullock carts. Probably they were doing what they were doing in their life, that they were painting on the surface. So you can see all their life recorded in their rock paintings. So again, we have more of Neolithic, Chalcolithic paintings, activities suggesting agricultural practice and several other activities, you know, human-like male figures, and they are also depicted, and animals, horned bulls, and they are also depicted in these images. Sometimes the megalithic burials also have images painted on them. So they also show that people painted on them for ritual purpose, or probably later people painted on this burial for some purpose or just to express their creativity. In the painting, in the historical period also, people were painting. The painting did not stop in prehistoric period, and rock art of historical period is distinct in nature. Sometimes Brahmi script, Kharosthi and even Shankar Libi, Nagari script are also painted in the rock shelters. The prehistoric rock shelters were also used by the people in the later historic times. So when people were traveling on the way in through the jungles and forests, they were resting nearby the shelters and they were scribbling their names or they were painting. Therefore, we need to be careful when we find a rock art at a site. We should not think it is entirely prehistoric. Even today, there are sometimes people who paint in the rock shelters. That is why we have to be very careful in the interpretation of these rock paintings and engravings found in the caves. Another interesting thing is the appearance of horses in the rock paintings. Sometimes horses frequently occur in some of the rock paintings. We can indirectly date these paintings. Horses were not there in the much earlier time. So on the basis of that, horses became very popular in South India only from the Iron Age time, because we find horse equipment in the megalithic burials. Therefore, when you find a horse image on a painting, we can easily date it to a slightly later period. So you find a lot of themes related to horse as well as human processions and other themes depicted in the rock paintings all across India, even in the historical period. Sometimes temple festivals are also depicted on the rock paintings. To conclude, these rock art are something very important. They are the very important record of our past when people did not have a script to write down their thoughts and actions. Therefore, they are very important. They tell us their way of life, their thinking, their artistic capabilities. So they are very important for our future generation. We need to preserve them. So rock art, by teaching rock art to the young children, we can create a kind of creative talent among them. You can understand how diversely people have painted rock art across the world, across India, and then that can be very creative point for the young kids to learn art. So far, we have seen a broad overview of rock art traditions of India, right from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, and I hope you understood the nitty-gritties of rock art world of India. Please refer to the e-text for more information on Indian rock art, and also there are several websites that give lot of information on new discoveries and also on rock art. You should consult them also to enrich your knowledge. Next time when you see people or others, tell them that rock art is very important, we need to preserve them. And also sometimes people tend to vandalize the sites of rock art. We also need to create an awareness among the people that rock art is very important, they should not be destroyed. Even if you have the urge, you can go to a village and discover a rock art of your own. India is a very rich country with a lot of heritage resources that need to be researched and documented. If you have interest, you may also one day discover a rock art in a remote part of India. Thank you.